hit edit, and it took me a minute to figure out that edit would let me go to the URL bar. And we'll go I'll go to one of the ones that the kids like to use. So we'll go Facebook. And you can see it's loading up the mobile version of Facebook by default. But I do have an option to go to the main site. So let's try that. See how the HTML engine renders. All right, so you can see the page is rendering. It's not the greatest HTML web browser, I have to say. Lots of carriers, and this is not a Sprint thing or a Lotus thing, but lots of carriers now are touting full HTML browsers. And I guess that's true. You know, they're not saying full JavaScript or full Ajax or what have you. But I don't know. When I'm hearing, you know, the real web, the full HTML web, that kind of thing, I'm looking for, like, an iPhone class browser, or an Opera class browser, or a Google G1 class browser, and this isn't quite it, you know. Anyway, but there's a look at the web. You can definitely get to more places than you can on many mobile phones, and the mobile optimized sites load quickly and look good, so that's good anyway. We'll go back here, we'll go to the messaging, and you can see the messaging interface. So you have your choice: text, picture, voice, SMS, or email. We'll go text, we'll go new address, we'll do the old 555-555-1212, and we'll cancel. And we'll do a little the quick brown font. So I'm really a big fan of this keyboard. I think it's just very easy to use. And again, you know, with the fonts, I know I'm harping on this, but this menu is nice. These fonts are smooth, easy to read, good size, but they're not that way uniformly across the phone. So there you go. But the messaging works well, and we won't save this. And let's close the phone. You can see on the outside what you can do with it. So press and hold the camera button to unlock. And now we're unlocked. And now we're going to stop the music. And we're going to fast forward. Oh, that's a good song, Red Hill Mining Town. I saw you two on the Joshua Tree tour like 80 million years ago. Good show. What's funny is actually about that show that I didn't know him at the time, but Megadug was actually working on the crew at that show, I believe. Or maybe another show I saw at the same venue. Anyway, you don't care about that. So we'll exit the music player and we will take a tour of, we'll go to YouTube. Now, like I said, the YouTube functionality wasn't working for me with that direct shortcut link, but I can enter a web address. And load up the YouTube. And so it recognizes, you know, YouTube now recognizes when you're on a mobile phone. And like I said, the mobile sites load really well. It's just the full HTML sites that the browser has a little problem with. So we'll go to pumpkin carving. And here's the media player. It goes right to the media player. And full screen mode. And there you go. So you can get your YouTube and you can, you know, like I said, you can buy music, you can sideload music. with a micro SD card slot. We'll take a quick tour on the side. We've got rocker switch. We've got the micro USB. The phone comes with a USB-based charger. You plug in there. You can also use that to plug in a data cable to hook the phone up to a computer. Other side, here's your card slot. Here's your camera button. Here's your music button. Here's your headphone jack. On the back, your battery cover. Your battery's underneath here. There you go. And then it's a nice soft touch, soft grip plastic. Very easy to hold, very comfortable. The rounded kind of corners here are nice, fits in the hand. I have a pretty big hand. My fingers aren't that long, but my hand is big. It fits pretty nice, it's very comfortable. And again, you know, you can use it one-handed for dialing, no problem. A little easier for a righty, but you can still do it if you're a lefty. And you can go two thumbs on the keyboard, definitely. And the camera quality was decent, not amazing, but definitely, you know, decent for a 2-megapixel camera. So here's the camera interface, and we'll take a picture. Take a picture of my little winter foliage here. And so there's my picture, and then I can send it if I want. See, there's that connect menu with the fonts. I know enough with the fonts, I'm sorry. I'm gonna go to the main menu here. And so here's actually your main menu. You're kind of surprising to find a main menu underneath all that carousel stuff. But here's the main menu. I'm gonna go to the photos. It's got a camcorder, PicBridge, so you can print directly from it. You can order prints with online service, all that stuff. And so here's options. Fun frames you can look at, you know, all those things. So here's my one picture that I took. And there you go. Self-portrait mirror, no self-portrait mirror, no camera, just 2.0 megapixel. So there you go, kind of an extended tour of the LG Lotus. And again, overall, you know, here's how it looks up against the face. First things first with this is the form factor. If you're not into the form factor, forget it. It's polarizing, some people like it, some people seem to really not like it. It also comes in a purple with kind of a scroll pattern on it. This is the black. I think that, you know, the design, I think whether you like it or not, it's very pragmatic, very cool how they're able to fit the full QWERTY in there. Like I said, it's a great QWERTY board. That's probably the highlight of the phone for me. It's a good display. I wish that the interface was a little more polished. It's just me. Some people probably won't care. They'll be like, what, enough with the fonts, Noah. But for me, it just kind of looks a little inconsistent. And the one click, like, it's a little busy for me. I'd like it to be a little more minimalistic. I'd like to be able to hide the whole thing entirely if I want to, or only have like two tiles on there or something like that. But I know what Sprint's trying to do, and I applaud them for trying to, you know, pack these phones with functionality but make them a little easier to use and a little more easy to customize. And unlike the Instinct, where you couldn't put a background picture at all on it, you know, you can here, which is good. And I like having the weather widget and the NBA widget. That's kind of cool. Like I said, a couple of call problems, most of the time was fine. A couple of the calls I made had some audio quality problems. People on the other end complained that they couldn't hear me. But in general, pretty good. And there you go. It's the LG Lotus for Sprint. I'm giving it a thumbs up, but I hope that Sprint works on the one click and they push out a new version that's a little more simplified. And a couple of the shortcuts didn't work for me, like the YouTube. I just had to punch it in. There you go. LG Lotus, Noah from PhoneDog.com. You're on the other side. We'll see you later. Don't forget PhoneDog TV, Wednesday, November 12th, 7 p.m. Eastern, 4 p.m. Pacific. It's going to be crazy. More details at PhoneDog.com/TV. See you later.